First up on this list is a 2020 release that didn't get much talk last summer, but is an amazing fragrance that honestly is just under the radar for most people, and I think you need to check out. What fragrance am I talking about? This is XX Artisan by John Varvatos. This is a fresh, woody citrus with the top notes of bitter orange and bergamot. Middle notes are Sichuan pepper, geranium, and wormwood. At the base, we have cedar, musk, and vetiver. Now, you may be wondering what's the difference between XX and my favorite John Varvatos fragrance, Artisan Pure. So Artisan Pure is an amazing fragrance, but I wanted to give you guys something new, and what I like about it is they complement each other. So Artisan Pure, this one's gonna be fresher, cleaner. It's gonna have more of the lemon, no pepper in it. It also doesn't have vetiver in the base. It's a good, long-lasting fragrance, but it's more of a day fragrance. XX is something you can take from the afternoon into the night with that little bit of pepper, with that vetiver at the base. In today's video, gents, I'm sharing with you my top summer fragrances for men. Next up, let's talk about Dolce & Gabbana's Light Blue. This is a fine fragrance, but if you have the chance, if you can find a deal on it, look for the Light Blue Intense. It's better, it's gonna be a little bit saltier, a little bit more oceanic, and it is gonna last twice as long. Now, if you want something brand new and you like the smell of grapefruit, check out Dolce & Gabbana's Light Blue Forever. This one just came out and I got to smell a sample of it, and I have to say it's absolutely amazing. Now, what I love about Forever is it lives up to its name. It's a long-lasting summer fragrance. I think it's the patchouli at the base that really enables this fragrance to last a good amount of time. That grapefruit, though, at the top is strong, it's realistic, and it comes through. Now, if Light Blue Forever is a little bit too expensive for you, you want something more affordable, check out the classic Issey Miyake's Odyssey Pour Homme. This one right here, you're switching out the yuzu for grapefruit in the Forever, yuzu here, but I'll tell you that both of these do a great job lasting all day, and they're very similar. This one just happens to be around for about 20 years. For these next three fragrances, they all come from the same house, Acqua di Parma. First up, let's talk about Colonia Intensia. This is a citrus fragrance, but as we get into it, it's warm, spicy, a bit aromatic. Top notes are bergamot, citrus, cardamom, ginger, Sicilian lemon. Middle notes, neroli, cedar, myrrh, guaiacwood, and artemisia. Base notes are leather, benzoin, musk, and patchouli. Now, compared with the original Colonia, I like this one a lot more. It just has a much more masculine scent to it. Now, what if you want something that's a little bit less citrus, more green, and more aromatic? Then check out Acqua di Parma's Colonia Club. Top notes are gonna be mint, neroli, petitgrain, lemon, bergamot, and mandarin orange. Middle notes, lavender, geranium, galbanum. Base notes are vetiver, ambergris, and musk. Now, a lot of people have compared Colonia Club to Green Irish Tweed by Creed. I would say that they're similar, but Colonia Club is fresher, better suited for the summer. That being said, I say my favorite Acqua di Parma for last, and that is Cinnato de Liguria. Now, guys, I gotta admit, before I smelled this fragrance, I didn't even know what a Cinnato was. I'd never been to Italy, but as soon as I smelled it, I'm like, wow, this is really unique. This is amazing. This is really nice. Now, I'm sure a lot of you guys that have been to Italy or you're from Europe, you know what a Cinnato is, but for me, this was a new experience, it was a new smell. And that's why, gents, I wanna introduce you to today's sponsor, Scentbird. Gents, Scentbird is a monthly subscription service that helps you discover fragrances, to be honest, you never would have found on your own. I mean, seriously, that whole Cinnato thing, I'm not gonna go out there and blind buy a fragrance I know nothing about, but with Scentbird, I was able to get a sample. I was basically able to date the fragrance before I go out there and buy a full bottle. When it comes to selection, they've got hundreds of options over on their website. In fact, they've also got quizzes that you can take to be able to help identify which fragrances you're most likely to like. That being said, I have to admit, I absolutely love the discovery process and how they carry cutting edge fragrances. Right here, Maison Sybarite. I'd never even heard of this brand, Paris 720. It's a beautiful scent, but what's more interesting is that this is actually a water-based fragrance. Yeah, that's why it's got this milky color. So I saw this, I thought, well, that's a little bit odd. I started doing some research and I didn't even know this when I initially ordered the fragrance, but apparently it's some new technology came out in 2019 in which they are infusing the oil right into the water. So it's not separating. So really interesting stuff. And if you were to go blind buy the bottle, it's $100. You get a sample here at Scentbird, and sample size is huge. This is enough for a month of wear. Now, the way it works, gents, is you go over to their website and you find your first fragrance. They've got hundreds of options, but find the one that's going to suit you. You're going to get your first sample in the mail. You've got about up to 120 to 140 sprays you'll be able to get from this thing. Free shipping, 100% authentic fragrances. Believe me, there are counterfeit fragrances out there. there. Guys, if you want to try a fragrance, you want to date it before you commit to a full bottle, Scentbird is the company you need to check out. Gents, I'm putting a link down in the description of today's video so that you can get the best deal on the web. Use that link, go over to Scentbird and save money. Again, gents, use that link in the description of today's video to make sure that you get the best deal on the web when it comes to Scentbird. Now, on a list like this, it seems like people always think they need to include Creed Aventus. I'm going to avoid doing that. Now, for today's list, I'm going to give you three other Creeds I think are better for hot weather. First up, we have Virgin Island Water. Now, a lot of people stay away from this because of the coconut note. Actually, if you've ever smelt it, I think it's amazing, and it works great in the summer. Yes, it doesn't last as long. I mean, it's a Creed. They don't last super long, but in the extreme heat, I think that this one is beautiful and I absolutely love it. Now, if your budget allows it, consider Millicene Imperial. Even by Creed standards, I have to say that this does not last long. That being said, it is a beautiful scent. If you can imagine like that salty water mixed in with melons, it is, yeah, this is heaven. One of the most beautiful scents I've ever smelled. And round the list off, I'm bringing in Aventus Cologne. Different than the original Aventus, this has a fresher, more citrus opening, and I think is actually better for the summer. Now, if the coconut note sounds interesting, but you want something for well under $100, something maybe it's a little bit sweeter and is gonna last, check out Le Beau by Jean-Paul Gaultier. Now, this 2019 release was not well received, and I think that's kind of sad because it's a solid fragrance. It's relatively simple, too. Top note is bergamot, that middle note is coconut, and the base is tonka bean. Longevity is solid, projection is solid, and because it really didn't pick up, there's a lot of them out there, and you can pick up this one for cheap. Now, another usual suspect you'll see on a lot of lists is gonna be Chanel's Allure Homme Sport Eau Extreme. This is a solid fragrance, but for summer, I'm gonna recommend something else. Specifically, Chanel Allure Homme Sport Cologne. So this is very similar to the Flankers, and it's a bit of an older fragrance, so you look around, you can find it on some pretty good deals. But this one is gonna be fresher, cleaner. It's not gonna have the cream that the other one has. This one right here is gonna be more citrus at the top. In fact, some people feel the top is very harsh. That being said, I think this is a great hot weather fragrance, and it has longevity. Now, what would a summer list be without Acqua Di Giò? So we've got the classic from the mid-1990s, and we've got Profumo. So this one right here, in my opinion, is the best Acqua Di Giò out there. It's just a little bit darker. It's definitely gonna last longer than the original. It's an amazing fragrance, but it may be a little bit too much during the day, especially if it's incredibly hot and you're sweating. And that's why I'm bringing in Profondo. So this one just came out a couple years ago, and I have to admit that this is more of the day wear. It's not as strong as Profumo. It's just under performance-wise, but it is stronger than the original. And what I love about this one is the stronger oceanic notes. They really come through, and this is a, if you're going to be sweating, you're going to be outside, you want something that's going to last all day and just have you smelling great, this is the fragrance you want to pick up. Now, I know some of you guys are on a tight budget. Still, you want something new. You want something that's gonna make you smell unique. You want something nobody else is wearing, something that's gonna make you smell amazing in the heat. Guys, check out Jaguar 4 Men Ultimate Power. Top notes are mint, lemon, bergamot. Middle notes, ginger, green leaves, and apple. Base notes, patchouli, white woods, and oak moss. Gents, this is a beautiful green, citrus, woody fragrance that I have to thank my friend Chad over at A Gentleman's Journey for introducing me to. And really quick, two other inexpensive options. We've got Nautica Voyage, which you'll see on a lot of lists out there, solid fragrance, and Ferrari Essence Musk. Now, gents, if you've ever watched one of these list videos and thought, well, that's stupid because that was number one on his list last year, but it's not even in the list this year. Yeah, do me a favor, smash that like button. And to explain myself, so I love Dior Hire. Absolutely beautiful pear scent, that note, amazing. But my understanding, it's discontinued. It's also well over $100. So I try to bring in a wider variety. And yes, it's still one of my favorites. I'll be continuing to wear it this summer. But yeah, this list, it just didn't make it. Seriously, gents, it's a tough job. I have so many great summer scents that unfortunately did not make today's video. All right, gents, so I know you got an opinion, and I know I missed a lot of your favorite summer fragrances. So let me know in the comments below what should have been on this list. So what video to watch next? How about how to properly wear a fragrance? Seriously, guys, so many guys out there are making mistakes when they're putting their fragrance on. They're wasting it. They're putting on way too much. They're choking people out. In this video, I explain to you how to apply a fragrance and the things you want to avoid when you're putting it on your body. So guys, go check it out. The video is right here.